dear guest is here
Hi,
right now.
praise the Lord.
Praise God, praise God. Sister Sutika Priscilla, she is live right now with us. So let me introduce her. She is from Basin, from Bangalore. She's anointed woman of God, and God is raising her up as a prophetic voice in these days and times. So we met in 2020. God connected us so divinely, and that was, we were so blessed last year when we got connected. And let me tell you, God has given her such a grace that she is having profound experiences, heavenly experiences. And she has released her experiences in her YouTube channel, and God is using her mightily. And she's one of the founders of Key to Heaven Ministries. And yeah, what more? In these days, God is raising up younger generation like never before. And she's the forefront forerunner in these times. Okay, guys. So let us hear from her what she want to say about this life. So, Sutika Priscilla.
Hi, Danny. I'm so glad. Thank you so much, first of all, for inviting me on this session. And I believe this is your first of your series that you're starting live. I pray that, you know, God will, this will be a blessing to many people. And thank you. It's a privilege that you've called me to be the first guest on this show of yours. So praise God. And like you said, for everybody who doesn't know, you know, I met Danny in 2020 during the pandemic. It's indeed a divine connection. The moment we met, we had such the like-mindedness, right? You know, this is the days where God is connecting us. He's bringing divine connections in place, like-minded people, kingdom-minded people, I can say. Amen. So we both were kingdom-minded, and you know, so it's so amazing to know you, Dad. So thank you so much. Amen. I'm super excited for this live. So I think the topic is, what is God's antidote for this pandemic? So we'll dive right in.
That's it. Yeah. We will dive in. So, so Sister Priscilla, let me ask you, what exactly is the pandemic that we are referring to? Why is this pandemic happening? And what is the pandemic? What is the real pandemic? Can you give the audience about a few nuggets about that? What is the real pandemic, and why is it happening?
Why is it happening? So I'll first address, why is it happening? What is this? Why is this pandemic? Why is this hit? So it's simple, right? We have the answers in the Bible itself, because this is nothing but it's simply the fulfillment of the prophecies which are written in the Bible. So there are many prophets who prophesied that in the end times, you know, perilous times are going to come. In fact, Jesus himself has spoken, and he said in the last days, you know, if you read in Mark chapter 13, verse 8, it says, nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There shall be earthquakes in diverse places. There shall be famines and troubles. These are just the beginning of sorrows. There shall be famines and troubles. So, you know, trouble is a word which is, it's a big word, right? Anything can come. You can put under the tagline of trouble. So today it's a time of trouble for the entire world. And you know, if you go into the other versions, it actually says, you know, deadly times, perilous times. It even says, you know, deadly diseases and epidemics will come, right? So if you would, this is just simple. It simply means that the Lord's coming is very near. Oh my God. So we just began the live and we are already talking about rapture, but guys, this is the reality. It's the truth. So Lord's coming is near, and these are just whatever you're seeing, this is just the beginning. So this is COVID-19. In the future, anything can come. In our past, this is COVID-420 or whatever can come. We just have to be prepared. This is just the beginning of, you know, greater things that are going to come. And the real pandemic that we're talking about today, I feel, you know, if we look into the world, I feel people are gripped with fear and anxiety, right? Mm-hmm. So this has resulted, this particular pandemic has resulted in a lot of people, you know, they have planned their lives. They have, you know, they've planned their future, especially 2021, you know, they might have had plans to travel, study, work or whatever. Everything has taken a pause right now. So now they're in a fix because they don't know what to do. They are, like, you they're know, stuck. Anxiety, worried about their future. They're stuck. Exactly. That's the right word. And people are fearful, you know, because now people are dying. Now it's like any moment it can hit them also. So they're like so scared. They're people are fearing death, right? So I feel the real pandemic right now that we are dealing with, apart from this COVID-19, is the pandemic of fear and anxiety. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Recently, I read one article about this fear. Fear is the root cause of, there is a mind-body connection with fear. This fear can affect our, it initially affects our mind, but gradually it will affect our bodies. Like fear, there are, even the fear can grip our bodies with serious damages. Like it will cause chronic impairment to the memory, PTSD, and a lot of diseases. A lot of diseases are byproduct of this fear. Fear and anxiety can affect our brain, hippocampus areas, and a lot of issues in our body we will experience because of this fear. And there are a lot of problems. I have written it down a little bit. A few of the problems that are caused by this fear, like weakening of the immune system, like brain processing and reactivity, everything gets disrupted because of this fear. So, guys, just like Jesus, guys, family members who have joined right now. So let me ask you guys, like, have you guys ever experienced this fear in your life, fear for anything, fear for unknown, fear for like failure, anything? Because there goes one quotation, like, everything you ever need is lying in the other side of the fear. So, guys, let me ask you. So, 20 guys are here online, and anyone, have you ever come across any kind of fear in your life? Hi, guys. Hello, guys. Like, have you guys ever come across any kind of fear in your life? Abby is telling, yes, we have experienced fear. Okay. Blessen has joined. Blessen is one of my friends. Hi, Blessen. Okay, so... there are many kinds of fear that we are being affected, and fear of failure and fear of this pandemic and everything. What Sister Priscilla was saying about this pandemic is exactly correct. Fear will cause more damage than the real problems that we are getting affected. Danny George said, yes, fear of future. Abby Samuel is telling fear of future. Yes.
Yes, everything absolutely.
That is happening inside our mind.
Yeah.
Is it right? Okay. So let me quote one Bible verse that God was telling in Timothy, in the book of Timothy. In the epistle of Timothy, God said that, I have not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and love and sound mind. So we can be sure that God is not giving this fear. God is the source of power, love and sound mind. So what do you think? Who is the source of this fear? What causes this fear in the people?
Yeah.
So what can you say
before about it? Yeah, before I answer that, thank you, Brother Aryan. Aryan from our church is joined. Thank you so much. He says he's so proud of us. Thank
amen,
you.
Amen.
And thank I think you, our friend Bindya has joined us.
Amen.
I remember talking to her. Yes. Thank you. So, yes, like you said, you know, fear... I feel fear is something, it's not just concerned about your mind or your body, but it's very spiritual, because we just read the scripture, right? In 2 Timothy 1:7, God has not given us a spirit of fear. That means fear is a spirit. So it's demonic. The fear is caused by devil. So fear comes from the devil. So, you know, I'd like to make an interesting point here. Fear and faith are like twins. They both are the same. So both are, you know, you believe what you don't see, you fear, or you believe what you don't see. Okay. So, but fear is on the negative side, but faith is on the positive side. So fear is, you believe that something will happen, some bad will happen to you, something bad will hit you. And faith is, you believe that something good is going to happen to you. So both are like sisters, you know, or twins, I can say. So it is caused by the devil. And like you said, very true that the fear, there's a mind-body connection, right? It's scientific. It's not just, it's proven science. Like the Bible says, of course, it's the spiritual aspect, but science says that it, like right now, this pandemic, the COVID-19 that we're talking about, it first affects your immunity. So basically, if your immunity is strong, if your immunity is good, you will be able to tackle this virus and you will be able to recover quickly. But if your immunity is low, then you will not be able to. What fear does is it hits your immunity. It reduces your immunity. You cannot, you know, fight that virus, because the moment fear hits you, 50% of your, you know, your life is already gone because you're scared. You cannot fight the virus. You cannot fight that sickness. And then over, the virus takes over and people are dying. So the people are saying that it's because of fear. Many, many, many people are losing their lives. In fact, even believers, they are going into this time of panic and fear. They're like, oh my God, we didn't expect this to come to us. And bam, they're losing their lives. They're losing their loved ones. So, you know, today we are going to fight this fear and we're going to speak about how we'll be able to overcome this fear. Yeah. Amen.
Exactly. So what is your point? How can we overcome this fear? Like the fear that is being affecting us. So from the word of God, what does God say about it? How can we fight with fear?
Yeah.
Because we came to the conclusion that God is not the source and devil is the source of this fear that is being instilled within us. So let the audience hear, like, what is the answer for this fear? Fear that is being instilled inside the minds of people that will be resulting in like physical diseases or anything, like disrupting their emotional life. Every area of their life is affected because of this fear. So let us know, what is the answer for this fear?
So you just have to replace, as I said, you have to replace this with the twin of fear, that is the faith. Replace fear with faith. So how can
we do that?
Yes, I'm getting to that. So how can we, build faith, or how can we replace, how can we get faith? The Bible says faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. So the more we feed ourselves with the word of God, the Bible, right? Danny, you and I were speaking, the Bible has every solution is there in the Bible for whatever trouble, for whatever you're going through. You have an anxiety, like Brother Abhi said, he has a fear of future, right? But you know what the Bible says, brother? That I have plans to prosper you and to bless you, not to harm you, says the Lord. So whatever troubles, you know, whatever we're going through, even fear, we can tackle with the word of God, faith. So as you hear the word, as we hear the Bible says, fear not, for I am with you. Be not be dismayed. Everything, it just hear the words, what Jesus has spoken or what the Lord has spoken in the word, and that will automatically give you that boost within you. And please make sure that you don't speak anything negative. See, whatever we're speaking right now, you're hearing that, right? When you say, by his wounds I've been healed, it is the word of God. I spoke it, or even you speak it and you hear it. So fear, as I said, faith comes by hearing and hearing the word. Fear comes by hearing and hearing the news. So the more you listen to all these negative news, people dying, or what this virus can do, third wave, fourth wave, fifth, we don't care. We do not care about what, how many waves are going to come. We are protected. The Bible says no plague shall come near your dwelling. Even if you fall sick, already the Bible says by his wounds you have been healed. So take the word, replace fear with faith.
Amen, amen, amen. So let me add on with one more verse. So even if you walk through the valley of shadow of death, you shall not fear no evil, because I am with you.
Hallelujah.
So like, remember all these promises, what God has said about you. Like, fear comes from listening to what the devil is saying about you, and faith comes from listening and hearing from what God has said about you.
Hallelujah.
So guys, the nugget that we have received right now is like, keep on saying what God said about you. Whatever fears that you are facing about your circumstances, about your future, about your finance, about your health, whatever it may be, start speaking against it. Start speaking what God has said about you.
Hallelujah.
What God has said about the situation. Start speaking about it and you will see what you say. Got it? You will see what you say. Okay, so guys, start practicing that. Start saying what God has said about you, what you wish to see in your life. Start saying that only. Don't speak fear. Okay?
Ooh, yeah.
So, so
I love what you said. You will see what you say.
Yes, exactly. You will see what you say. Okay. Yes. You guys take this note. Take this quotation. You will see what you say. So, yeah. So, let me get back to the title of our session, God's Antidote for the Pandemic. So, so let us be going straight away to the title and give the family what exactly is the antidote. What is the whole package of antidote that you are talking about?
Amen. So God's antidote for this pandemic, or God's antidote for your fear or whatever problems, whatever you're going through, God's antidote is Ephesians chapter 6, verse 13. It says, wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. That means take the whole armor of God. So when the day of evil comes, you will be able to stand your ground. Ephesians 6:13 is the antidote. That's the, you know, key. Please remember this. So I want us to note a key point in this verse. And if somebody can quickly, you know, just type out that verse, it would be helpful for everybody who's watching, right? So it's, you know, it does, the verse doesn't say, if the day of evil comes, the verse says, when the day of evil comes, you will be able to stand your ground. So the Bible is saying that the days of evil are bound to happen. Take it. It's a prophetic word already released in the word. The days of evil are bound to happen. We have no control over it, because at this point of time, the world is in the dominion of the Satan. The Satan is ruling and he's having the dominion over this world right now. So the days of evil are bound to happen. And today, at this point of time, this pandemic that we are talking about is caused by evil. People are saying, you know, some people are in this huge misconception that the pandemic is caused by God. God has sent this virus. God has sent this disease on people. This is a wrath of the people, a wrath of God on the people. God. No, 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 no. Please come out of that misconception, every single one of you watching this. God is a good God. His love endures forever. He does not do bad things. You know, then you can question, then why is this happening? This is happening because of the devil. Okay. And as I told you, we are living in the end times. In the end times, deadly things, perilous things are going to happen. It's already spoken in the word. But we have a solution to this problem, guys. That's what the Bible is talking about. Put on the whole armor of God. Put on the whole armor of God. We don't have time to read everything. And, you know, it's a huge topic. Armor of God is a huge topic. But I will give you a quick, a summary of what this armor is. All right. So first is the belt of truth. Okay. Gird your loins with the belt of truth, it says. So, you know, when in the warfare, right, it's not people don't wear a shirt and a pant. It's a full suit. And that entire suit is protected, or it's guarded with the belt. If the belt is gone, if the belt is loosened, the entire thing falls down. The entire, the suit just falls down. So you need to put around you the belt of truth, and then the breastplate of righteousness. You need to be righteous, the breastplate of righteousness, the helmet of salvation. Salvation is the key, right? That's the basic thing. The moment a person gives his life to Jesus, he is saved. He's received the salvation into his life, the helmet of salvation. And then, and then the shield of faith and the sword of the word of God, and your feet, readiness to preach the gospel. So this entire armor, the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, helmet of salvation, the shield of faith, sword of the word, and your shoes, that is readiness to preach the gospel. In this entire armor, you know, two of the most important weapons that we already touched upon, these two weapons already, is the shield of faith and the sword of the word of God, right? So the devil is trying to put his arrows. He's trying to throw his arrows at us. Faith, you know, faith is like a shield, the Bible says. So that shield is not like the small, tiny shield, okay? The shield, when you hold the shield in front of you, it covers your entire body, right from your head to the tip of your feet. It covers you. So when the devil is throwing his weapons at you, you are protected when you have the faith. And how can you build faith? With the word of God. Word of God is the sword. So he will throw bigger weapons. You cannot tackle with just the faith, but you need the word to destroy the weapons of the devil. So when you have these two go hand in hand, okay? You cannot separate faith with the from word. You cannot separate word from faith. Both go hand in hand. Faith comes by hearing and hearing the word. So faith and sword, these are the two weapons. Of course, the entire armor, but these two strong weapons are to be used in this time of the pandemic. This is the real antidote, which, amen, you know, the we spoke about. Hallelujah. Yes. So replace fear with faith. And how can you build faith? By hearing the word,
amen,
of God.
Amen. Amen. That's so powerful. Amen. Like a lot of guys, I can see the excitement.
Yeah. Thank you, Joel Evans. Joel Mirage.
Ethan has joined. Like, thank you, friends. Thank you, guys. You guys are awesome. Abhi, I guess you have received the answer for what you are selling, the fear of future, that you are facing the fear of future. So start, yes, declaring the word. The plans that God has for me is for your greatness, for your goodness. It's not to harm you, but to prosper you. So let me remind you one more thing about the verse. Like, faith comes by hearing. That is the verse that is being given in the Bible. So if we go to the root word of that, it is like continual hearing. So don't just hear or speak positively or speak good about yourself for one time, and like the next day you'll be starting to say negative about yourself. It will be like getting inside an elevator and like pressing the seventh floor and going up. When the elevator is going up, you'll be again clicking the like basement. You'll be going down. You start saying the negative word. Okay.
Yes.
So be focused. Consistently speak positive. Consistently speak life.
Confess the word. Yes.
Life about, exactly. What God said about your life, be consistent. Be consistent till you see the result. Speak about your life. Speak consistently. Positive things about your life. So let me tell you, I had this poll taken before the live began. And many of our friends have responded to that. And Tushar had said that the blood of Jesus is our antidote. That's also true. Like, you can confess it. Through the blood of Jesus, you are protected.
Mm, absolutely.
Patience.
Yes.
You have to have patience till you see the result. That is being said by Ferrande.
Yes.
And Sella Jackie said hope and love. And Stephen said that it's the Bible, reading the word of God. And Shia has said that it's prayer. Actually, everything is combined in the antidote. What Sister Priscilla has said, the complete package is the armor of God. It got everything that were mentioned by all of you guys. So
Danny, I want to cut you there. I'm distracted. There's this person. His name is D3 George. He's saying, if you have the entire armor, and how can we say that battle belongs to God? How does that work? Awesome. Good question.
That's Danny. That's one of my friends. Yeah.
Okay. That's a good question. You know, the Bible says that, you know, the moment you have accepted Christ into your life, he comes into you, right? He is in you.
Yeah,
exactly. Jesus is living in you.
Christ lives in you, the hope of glory.
The Christ lives in you. He's the hope of glory. So when you go into the battlefield, it's actually, technically speaking, it's not you fighting the battle, but it's the Lord within you helping you to fight the battle. And, you know, there's a man of God, he said this very beautifully. He said, you don't march for victory, you march from victory.
Oh, wow.
When you enter the battle, you don't enter the battle to win. You've already won.
Won the battle. 2,000 years ago, we have won the battle.
Yes, yeah, we have already won the battle. So when the Lord is living in you, he will fight the battle for you. You just have to put on. This is like a makeup. Like, you know, just the real battle, it belongs to the Lord. He's the one who's already fought it out, and you won the victory. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's so powerful. So guys, I'm so happy. Like, you guys have received the answer. Like, the real pandemic amidst these perilous days is fear. The sons and daughters of God doesn't have anything to fear, because we have already passed on to eternal life if we believe in Lord Jesus Christ. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. So keep keep on believing in Christ, have personal relationship with Christ. These end times and these perilous times, this is what
good
really
point.
Matters.
So, personal relationship.
And one more thing, like in these times, when Christ's return is too imminent, you guys have to speak about what you know about Jesus. I think that is the biggest mission
that
we have
the
to do
key.
These days.
Yes, yes. That
do
is
you
the
have
key.
Anything to say about that?
Like, yes, see, we have already won the battle. We already have the word. We have the weapons to fight these times. You know, there's this funny story I would like to say. So we had been on a ministry recently, and my dad was preaching in a church. So my dad asked a question to the church members, and he said, "What season are we living today?" Right? So dad was expecting like people would say, we are living in this deadly season, perilous season. You know what one of the church members answered? He said, "We are living in summer season." So, you know, I want us to know that this person is actually so amazing that he does not care about what's happening. We just have to care about the weather, right? Like summer season, that's it. Because for us, nothing is going to hit us. Nothing is going to harm us. We have the word, the living God, that we can fight this virus. We can fight whatever pandemic, whatever fear, whatever comes your way. You can fight this. It's just summer season. I don't know if people are watching. Maybe they'll watch from different other countries. Yeah, they're like, people are laughing to it. But yeah, honestly, that's so good, right? That's how you need to, that's how your mindset should be. People come and ask, they come and tell you, "Oh my God, this is the pandemic season, right? And how is it going for you?" You should tell, "I don't know. This is the best. I'm living the best of my days. This is the best time I've ever lived." So honestly, I think Danny, you and I, we can speak and we can say that this pandemic has turned out to be the best time for us. You know, I think, you know, we have our, you know, friends joining us. Was the supernatural meetings where we gathered for amazing time of revival meetings we had in the beginning of the pandemic. It was during I think it was in the last year of September. So we were having a time of our life. We were enjoying the presence of God, encounters. My ministry was unlocked for me during the pandemic. So for me, this has turned out to be the best. So ultimately, you know, I want to tell you that you don't have to worry about all. This is just kuch nahi hai. Like, yaar, you've already fought it. Okay, it's over. You have the word. You got the antidote. You know what you're supposed to do. But the main essence of the crux of this whole situation is each of you have a purpose of God in your lives. And each of you, you and I have to fulfill the purpose of God in and through our lives. You know, Danny, in one of my encounters that I had when I met the Lord Jesus Christ, right? He told me, these are the exact words that the Lord spoke to me. Please pay attention, everybody who's watching this. The Lord said, "I have crafted every single person's life with a lot of care and concern." I'll repeat that. "I have crafted every single person's life with a lot of care and concern." Yeah. That means the Lord has taken so much time to build your life, to prepare you. You are the Lord's masterpiece. And God has not just created you just for the sake of living in this world, come, eat, live, enjoy life and die and go back. No, you have a purpose. You have a greater purpose to fulfill. Everybody, I'm telling you guys watching this, everybody have assignments. The Lord has given assignments to you. He's assigned you certain tasks in your life. Yes, you may have your career goals to reach. Yes, you may have your career, you know, avigations and goals that you're supposed to reach. But all of that is just for the ultimate goal, the ultimate destiny. That is the Lord's purpose He has laid in your life. You may be in your college. God has placed you there so that you can be a blessing in somebody's life in your college. God might have placed you in the film industry. There, you're supposed to preach the gospel through your movies. You're supposed to preach the gospel. You're supposed to speak the love of Jesus to them. You may be working in a company. You're just there in probably whatever your company you're working in. There also, the Lord has placed you so that you have to fulfill His purpose. As I said, the armor, the readiness to preach the gospel. you should be ready to preach the gospel. Everybody is called to be an evangelist. Everybody is called to preach the gospel. Of course, there are offices, there are different calling, pastoral, you know, prophets or whatever, those are there. But ultimately, every believer is called to preach the gospel. And you have been assigned people to save. I'm telling you, you will be answerable. Let's say you worked in a company, okay, and in that entire time you've not spoken to one person about Jesus, and you're never going to meet those set of people again, okay, and you've moved on to another company. When you go to heaven, you will be answerable. Why didn't you speak to those people where I placed you there in the company? Why didn't you talk to them about me? We will be answerable for the souls that were unsaved, who could have been saved through our lives. So please take note of this. Everybody watching you, I believe, you know, God has great plans and purposes. Whoever has joined, these 28 people that have joined today, you have a greater calling. You have a greater purpose. I believe you are not here by accident, but the Lord has brought you here. You know, the Bible says many are invited, but a few are chosen. We put this out in the public platform. So many people are invited, but you are the chosen ones, the appointed ones. Now the numbers increased to 30 of you. You are the chosen, appointed ones to have joined this, so that your fire can be rekindled and you can be reminded once again of what God has placed in each one of your lives. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. That's so powerful. That's so powerful. And guys, that's the mission for everyone. It doesn't matter if you are an evangelist, if you are not an evangelist, you are not pastoring,
full-time ministry. No, it doesn't matter.
Wherever God has placed you, let your shine, lights shine so brightly, so that they will see the Christ in you. Okay, that's all. So it doesn't even matter, you have to speak. By your walk, by the talks, by the way you put up in your workplace or in your college, that's it. Christ in you will speak. They will be seeing a difference in your life, and they will start recognizing the Christ in you. That's what exactly is. And in between, I saw one brother, Sam Ebenezer. He was asking two questions, like, how can we get intimate with Jesus, and how to get encounters from God? So, Sister Priscilla, can you answer that question? Because she is having some profound experiences with God, and she has experienced it. So I'll be asking her if she can share some of her visitations of the Lord that she has received. So can you answer this question for Sam Ebenezer? Mm-hmm.
Yes, absolutely. You know, the first question that you said, how can we build intimacy with the Lord? You know, you have it. The answer, you already know it. How can you build intimacy with God? Or with, let's keep God aside. How can you build intimacy with any person? Let's say you have a new friend. How can you build intimacy with that friend? When you spend time with that person, when you hang around, when you hang out with that person, when you talk to each other, you share with each other about what has happened in your life, and you know, you have this conversation, these deep talks, that's when you will be able to build intimacy with another person, right? It's the same with Jesus. It's the same. You know, you need to talk to the Lord. You need to spend time with Him. You need to be, you know, give profound importance to prayer. Prayer is the key where you talk to God. And how does God talk to you? Of course, God talks to us through different ways. But one of the simplest and the easiest ways God talks to us is through the Word of God, the Bible. So take your Bible, guys. It's time you take the Bible. Okay, you take the Bible,
take because the Bible.
This has the written Word of God. Whatever God wants to speak to you is there in the Word. So when you talk, when you pray, you talk to God. When you read the Bible, the Lord talks to you. Simple. You build intimacy by communicating. It's a two-way communication. You cannot build a relationship. You cannot build intimacy with one-way communication. Let's say Danny and I, we're talking and only I talk and Danny doesn't talk. We're never going to bond, because I want his response, right? Yeah. So there has to be two-way communication to build intimacy. So word alone or prayer alone, you cannot get the full essence of God in your lives. Word and prayer both go hand in hand, and both are equally important. And coming to how do I get encounters from the Lord?
Yeah, please,
Danny, can we keep that as a suspense for another session, please?
Secret, yeah. Yeah, that'll be good. That'll be nice. Let's do one thing. Like that, we'll keep it for another session. So can you talk about that experience that you had about the rapture? We talked about the end times and perilous times, about the pandemic. Yeah. So guys, in short, the pandemic, the real pandemic that is affecting anyone in the entire world, is fear. Fear is that pandemic that is affecting the people. And like this virus that is affecting is a part of it, but perilous times are ahead. Like as the word said, evil days. These are the evil days. And we have to be girded with the full armor of God. As we have discussed about the antidote, that's the full armor of God. And continually hear words of faith and start speaking what God has said about you. What God has said about your circumstances.
Yes.
What God has said about your divine health. Always keep on speaking what God has said about you and you will see a change. Amen.
Yes,
so guys,
yes.
Can I hear an amen for that? And we will be moving on to that visitation Sister Priscilla got on rapture.
The rapture. Yes. So, you know, like I said, the Lord's coming is very near, right? And these, whatever is happening right now, the pandemic that's happening right now is just a fulfillment of the prophecies. And it's a clear sign for us that the Lord's coming is very near. Okay. So in one of my encounters when I had been to heaven, the Lord had taken me to heaven and I was there, you know, seeing all these angels around me. And I saw this one particular angel that was holding a huge trumpet, a golden trumpet in his hand. And then the Lord told me, you know what he told? This is the angel and this is the trumpet that will be blown on the day of rapture. So when the Lord comes with his angels in the midair, and when the rapture is going to happen, when the trumpet is going to be blown, that is the trumpet that is going to be blown. And I literally had the vision or the grace of God to see that trumpet. Literally that particular angel who was holding the trumpet is ready. It's like he's just waiting for the command from the Lord. He's just waiting for the command from the Lord to say, Om Prahante Kinko. He's just ready to say, go. And he wants to be released and come down. That's it. You know, he's just waiting. So right now, the most important thing is, you know, the Bible says the rapture will not come unless and until the gospel is preached to every part of the world. All the nations should hear the gospel. So right now, God is raising people to go preach the gospel to Lucan corners, to every part, to unreached places, right? So in our church, we have a few brothers who have joined us, right? We have had the privilege and the grace where our church had sent us out on a missions trip where we went to a village here in India in a certain place. They have never heard of the gospel, but God gave us the grace to go there. And our entire team, we were able to save around 1,500 souls. 1,500 souls gave their life to Jesus. And we were just the small set of people, but God is raising more people to go to the unreached places, to the tribal areas, to the, you know, to the Lucan corner of every world, so that the gospel will be, it's happening. The gospel is spreading like wildfire.
Amen.
The gospel is spreading like wildfire, and the Lord's coming is near. It is near. It can happen any moment, any time from now. You know, the signs are speaking for itself. Wars, rumors of wars, we have already been hearing in the news lately, right? And this pandemic that has hit. So everything, all the signs are speaking, and the Lord's coming is near. And I've literally seen that angel holding the trumpet, just waiting for the command of the Lord Jesus to say, go. So,
amen.
Guys, get prepared. Amen. You don't have to worry about what's going to happen in your future. Your future is secure in the Lord's hands. It's time for us to focus on what God has called us to do, that we may fulfill the purpose of God. Amen. And the Lord is raising young generation, young people to given the mantle, he's given the unction to so many people to go and do what he's called us to do and to go make disciples in this world. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen. 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 Guys, so that's it. That's how Christ's return is so imminent. So imminent.
Yes. Very near.
One brother said about, like, how can we be intimate with Lord Jesus Christ? That's the key in these days. You have to be falling in love with Jesus again and again, no matter what. No matter what, start loving Christ more and more. And there is a verse in the Bible says, perfect love cast out fear.
Fear, yes. So, hallelujah.
Perfect love, we can see the perfect love in the perfection of Lord Jesus Christ. And when we behold the perfection, that love that is being fanned into flame within us will cast out every fear that we have in our life about the pandemic, everything. So intimacy with Jesus Christ is a key. Put on the full armor of God and you will be a changed man in these days. You'll be a changed man. Like Saul was turned into Paul. You'll be completely transformed in your working place, in your college, everywhere. Everywhere, in your households, everywhere you are there, there will be the presence of God being manifested. So be focused on Christ in these days and make sure you wear, put on the full armor of God and speak words of faith alone always. So guys, I wanna conclude this session. Like Sister Priscilla, she will be praying over the entire family who has joined right now and the people who will be watching the replay, everyone who is attending the meeting right now. So I personally suggest each and every one of you to like get realigned with the Word of God and start seeking what God has said about you guys. And find your assignment, what you are supposed to do in these times and season. Not being carried away by self-centeredness or not being carried away by selfish desires, but be ye transformed by the renewal of mind and be focused on Christ. Okay, guys. So let me read some comments. Danny has said, I'm excited and waiting for the next section. Okay. Thank you, Danny. Living Waters has said, Spirit and the Bride says, come Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, the return of Lord Jesus Christ is imminent. Brother Ruben has joined. Thank you, guys. Thank you. So, Sister Priscilla, as I have mentioned earlier, she is an amazing woman of God and she is being used mightily by God in these times and season. And her ministry, she's a founder of one of the founders of Key to Heaven Ministries. And you can reach out to her in her YouTube channel. And she has started releasing videos on that, right? You have started releasing videos on her experience with the angels, the book of assignments and everything. She has started releasing videos and you can log into YouTube and check out the videos and you will be blessed. So can you pray a blessing prayer over everyone who has joined and will be watching the replay and everyone.
Definitely. Yes. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Worship your master. Rekanda la karaba shankre de endo kobra ande la karebon so karibra anda makala kura ba shankre do hondo leri da bankara bahando lo kura ba shekri do ombra ande bo sakri do ombra ande bosha. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful opportunity that you have given to us, and Father God, to speak, Lord, on what you have in store for us. That, Lord, everything, we have the solution in the word, O Lord Jesus. I believe the people who have joined us today, their lives will never be the same again in Jesus' name. I commit all of these 26 or 27 people that are watching. I release a divine favor of God upon each one of them. Rabandere kembra onga rabashanda lahande rokombra onga redu hade rokombra ande bo shankri rabandera bahando bo ompro sefe tu rabandere kembra ombra ande bo shakira bandera bahante. I don't know if this that brother Abhi, you were just messaging, right? I don't know if you're still online. Please do just send a message if you have, if you're still online. You know, I have a word for you. Hallelujah. Lord, I believe, you know, I believe the Lord has appointed you for this time, right? For this end times, that God has appointed you and he's going to use you in the ministry. I don't know if you've ever thought about it or if you've ever focused on it, but the Lord is, I was just reminded of you. I was not even planning to pray or anything, but as I was praying, the Lord was leading me to give this word to you, that God wants to use you. He has a mantle upon you. He has a calling in your life, Brother Abhi. I forgot the entire ID, his name, but I believe the Lord has appointed you for this end time, that you will be somebody who will bring forth a revival in your community, among your people. You're going to break those chains. You're going to break those mindsets, and God is going to use you mightily and powerfully in their lives. Brother Abhi, you were just watching. Hallelujah. Reko Shankra ba ande bo karibra onga zabahande lesi kindo robo karade bra onga da bashandra makaruso refunta di karaba ande bo shontra ma ande bo lo kondo robo onko. Eva Ash, you've been active. I believe God wants to encounter you. The Lord wants to meet with you. He's desiring to meet with you. He wants to meet you, dear sister. So I want you to take them. I'm giving you this prophetic instruction, okay? okay, take time to fast and pray in this next week. The Lord wants to encounter you. He wants to meet with you. You know, he wants to raise you to be a mighty woman of God for this time. And he has something in store that he wants to speak to you, and he wants to give you a personal encounter. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you will have a personal revelation of Jesus Christ in your life, Sister Eva Ash. Reko som pradiko labanke rebo sankri do onka la de onkre be enga lefro do bashika raba ande le kendo robo hundo la bahande. Father, I pray for every single person who's even going to watch this recorded live, this recorded video, live video as well. I believe, Father God, that I right now I release an impartation upon them that they may receive the grace of Father God. Whatever that was released at this point of time, they will receive the grace. A grace will be released upon them in Jesus' name, and their lives will never be the same again in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I believe, Lord, that you are going to bring a turnaround in the lives of the people in Jesus' name. Maka rekondo robom karaba ande bosha. I pray for this Just Like Jesus page members, everybody who's been following this page. I believe, I declare and decree that this page will be a blessing to multitudes of people, more and more people. I declare and decree in Jesus' name, there will be millions of followers of Father God who will be blessed through this page of Father God. And you will connect so many people to Danny in Jesus' name, that he will be an in turn a blessing in the lives of all those people who are going to follow this page and going to support this page in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Reko zonkra de bonga rabahande, ledin karaba debo shandri makadahande, leku rabande bo zonkra de bonga rabande rabashada rabanda bande, leki rabanda rababa. Lord, I believe a lot of people, you're instilling hope into the lives of so many people today in Jesus' name. Lord, their hopes are being rekindled in Jesus' name as they put their hope and their trust in you and in the word of God. Their lives are never going to be the same again in Jesus' name. I prophesy that everybody who is watching this video today, right now, this live and even the recorded version, their lives will never be the same again, and they are going to see the hand of God upon their lives, and they're going to write testimonies. There's going to be a divine turnaround and divine shifts taking place in the seasons of their life in Jesus' name. As they step into this new season of grace, new season of restoration, new season of breakthrough and reestablishment, I pray, Father God, the people's lives, they will write testimonies of the goodness of God in their lives from today onwards in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord. I give you the glory and honor. In Jesus' mighty and wonderful name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's so powerful. Powerful session. Wow.
Praise God. Yes. Okay. Brother Abhi.
Thank you guys. Thank you. Just Like Jesus family, you guys are amazing and you guys are blessed. I believe you guys are blessed and I know you are blessed. So if you have any testimony of change, like anything that is going to happen in these days, or whatever you experienced, or whatever is going to, you are going to experience in these days, please write to us and follow Sutika Priscilla. That is her ID, and she is an amazing woman of God, I'm telling you. And to listen to her about the visitations, visit Key to Heaven Ministries. Key to Heaven Ministries in YouTube channel. You will be able to listen to the entire visitations that she is being receiving, and you will be changed. So in a nutshell, let me tell you, fear not. As Jesus has said, I am repeating and reminding you again, fear not. Always keep faith. What you want to see, you'll be saying according to the word of God. If you say it according to the word of God, God will never say no. You'll get it. You'll get it. And have intimacy with God, guys. Have intimacy with God, guys. So put on the full armor of God. That is the antidote. And have intimacy with Jesus. So that is the end note. I want to say, like, do you want to say something? Like, end note? Like, do you want to give a word over the people who have joined right now? 36 people are there.
Yeah, now more people have joined. Yes. You know, I request the people who have just joined, please do go back and watch this entire live, because there's something really God has in store for you guys. So I don't want you to miss out on what God has in store. That, you know, you will, we've spoke about how you can you know, battle this pandemic and what is the solution. And from the word we've spoken, so please do go back and watch. And I want to personally thank everybody who has joined us, like, you know, our friends like Evans Mirajkar, you know, Suhas has joined, and Aishwarya Chechi, thank you for joining, and Bindya, and all of these people. I want to personally thank each one of you for joining. Even there's one of my auntie, her name is Geeta, she's also joined us. So thank you for joining, and I request you to please share this, you know, even the recorded version, once this is posted, do share it, because I believe somebody will be blessed and touched. And Danny, as you know, we promised them next time we'll talk about my encounters, how to have the encounters, right? That's more important, not just sharing my encounters, but to really help people also to unlock the same grace, right? Amen. So that's more important. Amen. So we'll have another session on that. Yeah.
Amen. Amen. We'll have a session on that, how to have godly encounters, and God will encounter you in these times and season, because time is too short. God wanted to move mightily in this earth. And so stay tuned, and we will have exciting sessions coming up in this SUA series, Christ's Mind for Classy Life. You, all of you guys need to have renewed Christ's mind to lead a classy life in these days until the rapture.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 God bless you guys.
Bye-bye. Stay tuned. You are blessed and highly favored.
God bless you.